After classifying materials with the help of the taste they have or the touch we notice, we have another criteria, that is using indicators. Now, indicators, as the name indicates, is something which will just point towards something, indicate something. So these are actually the substances which help in indicating whether a particular substance which we are using is an acid or a base. Now, because it is not possible for us to taste every material, and rather it is not advisable to taste every material, same way it is not possible for us to touch every material, and again that is also not advisable to touch every material. So the best way we can use is to opt for some substances where we can just categorize the substances into acid and base without tasting or touching, and that we can do is by indicators. Now, indicators actually are the substances which indicate whether a particular material is an acid or a base. Now, we have a number of indicators around us. Some indicators are natural. We can categorize into two categories. There are certain indicators which are natural, and we have another category, that is synthetic indicators. Synthetic means the indicators which are actually not present in nature but prepared by human beings. Now, the natural indicators which are given here are your turmeric. Turmeric can be used as an indicator. Then litmus. Litmus obtained from lichens, and China roots. These are the three main indicators which are present naturally and can be used to test whether a particular substance is acid or base. Second, we have synthetic indicators. Synthetic indicator is phenolphthalein and we also have methyl orange. Methyl orange is not given in NCERT, but still we do tell this so that it will be easy for you to have a broad idea of certain synthetic indicators. Now, this I have just mentioned that which indicators we are going to discuss in detail. Now, I will pick one by one and will tell you how these indicators will help in detecting whether the substance is acid or base. The first indicator which we will be reading in detail is litmus. Now, litmus is actually an indicator which is available as solution as well as paper strips. Both way we can use it and it will be convenient. Now, litmus is actually a dye. Dye means something which is giving you color. So it is basically a naturally obtained dye, and it is obtained from what? It is obtained from lichens. And everybody must be knowing what are lichens. Lichens are basically the organism in which an alga and a fungus live together in close association. So lichens help in giving litmus. We can obtain, or we can say, we can obtain litmus from lichens. Now, litmus is actually a purple colored solution, purple colored dye in distilled water. Distilled water means the water which is free of all the impurities and generally used in laboratory for doing all the activities, because it will cause no disturbance in the reactions. Okay, so purple colored this solution we will get of litmus. If we will add this purple colored solution into an acid, then the color will come out to be red. And if we use this purple colored solution in the base, then the color will come out to be blue. Now, acids will turn the purple colored litmus solution to red color, and bases will turn the purple colored litmus solution to blue color. This is how we can use the litmus solution for checking whether a substance is acid or a base. One, I have told you that we can use the litmus solution for testing whether the solution is acidic or basic. Another way is by using the paper strips. These are the litmus paper strips which are available in two colors, red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. Both the strips will behave differently with acids and base. So how do they behave? Like I'm taking certain acid and certain bases, so what I have to do, I have to take red litmus strip and I have to dip into one of the solution which is acid. When I will dip this red litmus paper into acid, I will notice there will be no change in color of the strip. It will remain as such. But if I will dip this red litmus paper into a basic solution, then I will find that it will turn out to be blue. And when I will use the blue litmus paper strip and will dip into an acid, the color of the strip will change to red. And when this blue litmus paper strip will be dipped in a basic solution, there will be no change in color. So it is no change in color. So what I have got? I have got different color change or somewhere no color change on dipping the litmus paper strips of different color in different solution. So let us just have a quick look. I have not been able to know whether the particular substance is acid or a base. I have no idea. So how it will help to me? I am taking a red litmus paper strip and dipping it into the solution. If the color of the strip will not change, it means my substance is acid. Now I get an idea. This is an acid. But if the color of my red litmus strip will change to blue, it means the substance is base. Okay, now this will help me in identifying. Same way, I am taking blue litmus paper and when I am dipping it into any solution, I don't know whether it is acid or base. And if there is a change in color from blue litmus paper to red, it means my substance is acid. Okay, and if there is no change, means the red litmus paper strip will remain red litmus paper only, then means the color will not change, the blue litmus paper strip will remain as such, it means my substance is base here. So this way I will get an idea whether the particular substance is acid or base using the paper strips. Solution can be used, that is okay, but actually the paper strips, these come out as strips like this size strips are available, either it can be of blue color or of red color. So that will be convenient to use. We have to just dip the strip into the solution and then we will get the result. So it is considered as a very fast and convenient way of testing whether a particular solution is acid or base. Then sometimes indicators will not show change in color if we are using neutral solution also. Neutral means there are certain substances or solutions which show no change with any of the indicator. Like we have distilled water. Now distilled water is actually neutral. How I can check? Once I will put the red litmus paper strip in distilled water, it will show no change. Then again, what I can do is I will take a blue litmus paper strip and dip in distilled water. Again, there will be no change. Means any solution or substance which is not showing any change in color with any of the indicator, it means it is neutral in nature. Distilled water is neutral in nature, and this is the reason when we are making the solution of litmus, then we are using distilled water because it will show no change of itself. So neutral solutions can also be present, and we can just use red litmus paper and blue litmus paper strips for finding out a particular substance's acid or a base.